The Desert Challenge Games are back in Mesa this week. Over 300 para-athletes from across the world all jumping into Mesa this week with Paralympic-style events. We are joined by the director of sports at Visit Mesa, Lance Feit. And this is an absolutely massive event, from the over 300 athletes to the coaches, the parents, the friends, the families, and of course all the volunteers who make an event like this possible. What does an event like this do, not just for the community and the Paralympic community, but just for the city of Mesa itself as well?
Yeah, it's honestly, it's one of those things that is close to our heart here in Mesa, that we get to showcase everything that Mesa has worked for to be prepared for athletes of any ability, parents of those athletes. We really get to showcase how much we've been trying to be better prepared, more equipped. And we get to flex all of that, and while also having just a phenomenal top tier Paralympic qualifying style event. And it takes over such a huge footprint of Mesa, you know, from aquatic centers to a track and field to a high school to a college to the Broadway Rec Center. It just has such a huge footprint, and we love having it.
And this is an annual event every single year. And on top of that, it's not just like the competition days at the end of the week. Practice starts at the beginning of the week. It's a week-long festival, if you will, going on in Mesa. What's kind of the goal for you guys, for the city, to continue bringing this kind of atmosphere and bringing this kind of event to Mesa every single year?
Like I said, this is one of only three like it in the world. So the fact that we host it here, we have a bar set years ago, and we try to raise that bar every year. So all planning aside, all committees aside, all financials aside, there is a very high bar set, and Mesa loves raising it every year. And as much as these questions sounded like, you know, I'm answering it from a Visit Mesa standpoint, anything you can do, you know, obviously it means a lot to us, but this is all about the athletes. As much as we love to have our hands in the mix and help out along the process, it literally is Arizona's disabled sports baby. It is the World Series every year. This is the one event that they market for. We help them market for it. We help raise the funds. They help raise the funds. They build a village, a local operating committee. It's about the athletes, and it's about them. It's not about us. It's just, we're just so proud to have our tongue on it, because it checks so many of our initiative boxes that we want to be as a destination. And we just, it's this thing that we love having, because it really does let us showcase everything we work towards as a destination, to have this and showcase that we can do it on such a large scale.
And it is across the world. We have people coming from across the world to participate in all the festivities going on, and including the University of Arizona. They bring a ton of athletes from their adaptive athletics program. How do you kind of see the world of adaptive athletics changing here in the state of Arizona? And of course, I'm sure as you're interested in Mesa as well.
Yeah, being a proud board member of Arizona Disabled Sports, I get to kind of get a firsthand view of what our local adaptive community needs. So then you put that, I partner with Move United a ton, and I learn from them on what other destinations are doing in the adaptive sports world. And then you can kind of, you know, compare notes. What is maybe Seattle doing? What is Dallas doing? What is Florida doing in the adaptive communities? And then we try to, okay, let's go back to our demographic and our community and think, okay, does any of this hold any value here with our community? And then we build on that. I think, you know, Mesa really has its grasp on being the only autism certified city in America. We've since springboarded off of that and spread that message to try to get other destinations to go with IBCCES and get their accreditation to be autism certified, because it really shows that your destination is prepared for parents and people on the spectrum, or parents who are traveling with those on the spectrum. We've since springboarded from that to try to be an all-out accessible destination, completely of any ability, disability, adaptability. Any chance I get to bring my adaptive sports world into it, to add an adaptive clinic to baseball championship. This last week, we added an adaptive golf clinic to the NAI Men's National Golf Championships that we're hosting. Any chance I get to really flex our muscle and get our adaptive community involved into sports of any kind is just furthering our platform.
Man, such a fun event. Lance, thank you for joining us. Be sure to check out the Desert Challenge Games all week long across the city of Mesa this week.